Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina safa ma ba'd. Qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fil kalam al-majid wa furqan al-hamid. فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله العظيم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صام رمضانا ايمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه او كما قال عليه الصلاه والسلام my respected brothers elders السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته الحمد لله All thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who's most kind, most merciful, most loving. Alhamdulillah, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has given us this opportunity. Today is Yomul Jummah. And also we are in this blessing month, month of Ramadan. Lot of our brothers and mothers and sisters, they were with us last year, but today they are not with us anymore. We are very fortunate people. We always try to thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has given us this opportunity. We try our best, inshallah, to do whatever we can. Get the full blessing and reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The month of Ramadan is a month of blessing. The month of Ramadan is a month of appreciation. Thanking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Appreciate the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a month of patience. This is a month to exercise patience, and this is a month of sharing and caring with one another. The person who look after others, Allah will look after them. If you open the door for others, Allah will open His rahmah, His door for you. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam have said one hadith, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أوله رحمة. هذا الشهر, this is a month. The first Ashra is the Rahmah. The people who are fasting in this blessing month, month of Ramadan, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala descend His Rahmah and mercy upon those people. وأوسطه مغفرة. And the second 10 days is a Maghfirah. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala forgiving the sins of the people. Because they fast to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they recite the Quran, they come at night to stand in the Salatul Tarawih, they cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they get up in the morning for suhoor, for tahajjud. Then the second 10 ashara, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the maghfirat, clean the sins of the people who are begging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last one, وَآخِرُهُ إِتْكُمْ مِنَ النَّارِ. In the last 10 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the sins and Allah make the maghfirat for all the people. That's why there is a hadith mentioned that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once, he climbed on the minbar. Once he put his step on the fest, then he said, Ameen. You heard this hadith from the ulama. When he put another feet on the second step, he said, Ameen. When he put his third step, then he said, Ameen. After the khutbah, after Salatul Jummah finished, the Sahaba, the companion, they came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they asked this question, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we heard something from you today. We never heard this before. What is this about? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he explained his Sahaba, his companion. He said, when I put my first step, when I put my feet on the first step, Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam came. Allah Ta'ala sent the Jibreel. Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he came. He said, Oh Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mentioned, I will destroy those people who found the month of Ramadan and they don't ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ameen. When I put my second step on the member, Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala destroy those people who in front of them, when the Prophet's name is mentioned, they don't send the durood on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You must say salatu wasalam on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You must read durood sharif all the time. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ameen. When he say, I put my feet on the third step, Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, Allah destroy those people who have got the parents, father or his mother, they have reached to old age and they are alive. And the children, they don't make khidmat of their parents to get enter into Jannah. I said, Ameen. My respected brothers and mothers and sisters, we must understand, and this is a month of Ramadan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the door of His rahmah. Allah opened the door of His mercy. If we have got our parents alive, we must make their khidmat. That's why one of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, under the feet of your mother is paradise, and your father is a door of Jannah. You have to make the khidmat of our parents. Take the dua from our parents. One of the hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have says, when the children, they make dua for the parents, or the parents make dua for the children, this dua goes direct to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah accept the dua, mustajab. And this is a blessing month of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Inna fi kulli yawmin wa laylatin da'watan mustajabatan. In this blessing month of Ramadan, every day and night, one time is so important that when you make the dua, Allah accept the dua. The ulama have mentioned that the best time of making the dua, the time of iftar. When we sit down on the sufra, now our iftar is ready now. We are going to break the fast very soon. This is a time you lift your hand and cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is Ghafur Rahim. Allah is waiting our call that my servant is going to ask me, I'm going to grant him. But sometimes we are so busy ourselves, we don't have a time to make the dua. We encourage one another. Brothers, make dua in the time of iftar. Don't talk. Try to concentrate, communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens his door, opens his rahmah, opens his maghfirah, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah ta'ala will respond our dua. You know that when we make the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must understand there is three ways how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our dua. Three ways Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is going to accept our dua. Number one, when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you whatever you like, whatever you wish. Allah knows that this person is asking something, grant him, number one. Number two ways, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, Allah give you something different. Because Allah knows more better than others. Allah knows our ahwal. We say, Ya Allah, give me a very fast car, Ya Allah, Ferrari. I can go to the masjid very quick. Then Allah give you a bicycle, a motorbike, something like that. Because Allah knows this person, he drive very fast, he will kill himself and he destroy others. Allah knows. Sometimes the hikmah, the wisdom, we don't know the hikmah of Allah. This is number two. Number three, sometimes you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah don't give you nothing. Allah don't give you anything. And the people, they say, Ya Allah, people say, complain, I'm making the dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dua is not mustajab, I'm not getting anything. It is mentioned one of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, on the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command angel to call that person, call this Abdullah, tell him to come, and Allah will ask him, the angel, to tell that person, that is a big palace I have made for you in Jannah. Then that person, he will think himself in his heart and his mind, Allah is going to give me so big palace in Jannah. I was not very pious person. I never do my lot of activities. I was like a normal person. How big palace Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is giving me in Jannah. He will be shocked. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind him, do you remember the certain time you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Allah ta'ala store your dua for the akhirat. That dua which you have asked in the dunya, I have given you the badal in the akhirat. And that person, then he will wish, Ya Allah, all those dua was accepted in the dunya, is better you store it for the akhirat. That's why it is one of the ayat in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said, La taqnatu min rahmatillah. Don't lose the hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala is Ghafoor Rahim. Allah have got lot of treasures. Allah have got nothing less that Allah cannot give to the people. Allah ta'ala wish Allah can give everybody equal, but Allah have got so many. That's why the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained his Sahaba, he have advised his Sahaba, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Jannah, ask Jannatul Firdaus, because Jannatul Firdaus is the highest state in Jannah. We are in this blessing month of Ramadan, we are fasting. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have said one hadith, this is a hadith of Qudsi. Allah ta'ala says, As-sa'imu li wa ana ajzi bi. A people, they are fasting for me and I am going to give the reward. Look, if somebody recites the Shahada, how many pillars in Islam? 5 pillars in Islam. Number 1, Shahada. If somebody recites the Shahada, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, we can see a person, he is reciting something. Understand? Number 2 is Salah. If somebody is performing the Salat, he's going up and down, then we know that that person is doing the Salat. We can see. You people understand my language? Number 2. Number 3, Zakat. Giving the charity. If somebody is giving charity, is giving the Zakat or donation, he's taking the money and giving to somebody, a person who is giving, you can see he is a giver. Somebody receiving, you know he is getting the money. Understand? Number 5, Hajj. If somebody is going to Hajj, if somebody is going to Hajj to perform Hajj to Makkah, everybody knows because he buy the ticket, he apply for the visa, he's packing his bag, he meeting one another, brothers, make dua for me, please forgive me, I'm going to Makkah to perform the Hajj. But what about the fasting? Fasting is something very secret ibadah. Very secret ibadah. I am sitting in front of you. How can you know I am fasting or not fasting? How do I know you fasting or not fasting? Is not written on anybody's forehead. This person is fasting and that is not fasting. Because a person, when he or she is fasting, is a secret ibadah. This is between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person, he have got food to eat, he can eat, but he is not eating because he wants to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have got a lot of drink at home, but we're not drinking because we try to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, As-sa'imu li wa ana ajzi bi. A person who is fasting for me, and I am going to give the reward for that person. You imagine, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised that I will give the reward of the fasting, how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give you. That's why, my respected brothers, this is a month of Ramadan. It's going very fast. Today we have started the first Ashra. The time will come, will be in the end of the Ashra. I told you before, how many our brothers and mothers and sisters, they are not here today. They have departed from this dunya. They're muhtaj. They cannot read one subhanallah. They cannot fast for one day. They cannot do one rakah salat. They cannot recite the Quran. But alhamdulillah, Allah has given us this opportunity. One of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have said to the fasting person, Inna fil jannati babun yuqalu lahu al-rayyan yudkhilu minhumus sa'imun. Allahu Akbar. On the day of Qiyamah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the announcement to the angels, find it out, Aina sa'imun? Aina sa'imun? Where are the fasting person? Come forward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have designed a special dua in Jannah. The name of this dua is Ar-Rayyan. All the fasting people will come and enter into Jannah from this dua. When they enter into Jannah, then dua will be closed. This is a respect, the honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those brothers and mothers and sisters who are fasting in this blessing month of Ramadan. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to the Sahaba, very good hadith, listen this hadith. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Man sama sa'iman, whoever tried to break the fast of the fasting person, qana lahu maghfiratun li dhunubihi wa itqun minan nar. If somebody break the fast of a fasting person, Allah will forgive all his sins, and Allah will make him free from the Jahannam. If we are free from the Jahannam, then inshallah 100% we are going to enter into Jannah. The Sahaba say, the companion say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, laysa kulluna najidu ma yufattaru bihi sa'im. They say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are so weak. It's true, my brothers. The time of the Sahaba, they don't have enough food to eat. Some of the time of the Sahaba, they take one date and they go in the battlefield. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to his daughter, Hazrat Fatima. Then she starts crying. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, my daughter, why are you crying? She says, oh my father, I'm crying because you came to me. My father came to visit me and I don't have enough food myself for the family. What can I feed for you? That's why I am crying. Brothers, when our parents come in our home, we were so happy. We feed them so many food because we got a lot of things in our home. But the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Fatima, she is crying. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he calmed down to his daughter. She said, don't cry. My daughter, don't cry. I am a prophet of Allah. And he removed his shirt. He said, look, my stomach. I tied 2 stones on my stomach because of the hunger. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, oh my daughter Fatima, if I wish, I ask Allah, Allah will turn this mountain into gold and the silver. But I didn't ask Allah to give me this dunya. We ask Allah for the akhirat. You make sabr in this dunya, be patient, inshallah Allah will enter, make you enter into Jannah. That is a sabr. This is a month of Ramadan, we have to exercise patience. So many our brothers and mothers and sisters, they are living in different countries. They don't have enough food to eat and drink, I'm telling you. The Sahaba say, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we don't have enough food ourselves to eat. How can we break fast for the other people? Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he give reply. What he replied? Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man fattara sa'iman ala mudghati labanin aw tamarin aw sharbatin mimma. If you are going to break the fast of the fasting person with one glass of milk, if you don't have one glass of milk, then one tamar, one dates. If you don't have one dates, then one glass of sharba, one drink, anything from the glass, maybe water, and break the fast for the fasting person, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. Allah will make your maghfirah. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, man ashbaha sa'iman. If somebody feeds a fasting person full stomach, mashallah, we feed the people here full stomach, mashallah, we got a lot of food here. Man ashbaha sa'iman, shakahu Allahu min hawdi sharbatan la yazmahu hatta yadkhul al-jannata. If somebody feeds a fasting person full stomach, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow that person to drink from the Hawdi Kawthar. Hawdi Kawthar is a pond in Jannah. The day of Qiyamah, when the people will be so much thirsty, they got no water to drink, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow those people to drink from Hawdi Kawthar one glass. When they drink one glass of water from Hawdi Kawthar, they are not going to get hungry and thirsting until they enter into Jannah. That's why when the people, they go to Makkah, you realize when you drink Ab-e Zamzam, the water of Zamzam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ma'i Zamzam, Zamzam shifa'un min kulli da. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the water of Zamzam is a cure from all the sickness. If a person, he have got the full intention and he got the connection with Allah, inshallah, you make the niyat and you drink, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cure your sickness. But sometimes the people, they say, Sheikh, I drink, I got diabetes, but still the diabetes is not going away. That diabetes Allah has given you, this is shifa. I'm telling you, the shifa, because it is mentioned in the hadith, if a person, he or she is sick, any kind of sickness, this is a shifa, this is a rahmah from Allah. How long you are going to be sick, you are going to, getting a problem and difficulties in your life, that much sins Allah is going to wipe out from your life. Sometimes that's why a lot of people, they are dying with cancer. Cancer people are sick long time, Allah Ta'ala cleaning their sins. And then when they clean out, mashallah, then Allah Ta'ala take the ruh and they take them away, they die like a shaheed. Mashallah. That's why if somebody have got a sickness, you should not run away from the sickness. This is from rahmah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, my respected brothers, we don't have a time on Yomul Juma, Friday. The time is very fixed. Always Imam, they give advice. You must finish the Salat Bayan before the time, because there is some announcement. But what I am trying to say, brothers, if you have got this opportunity, alhamdulillah, don't waste your time. Try our best as much as you can and try to make the iftar. If you don't have somebody to make iftar, there is a lot of people, they're collecting the money from overseas. You can send it to overseas and make the iftar for the needy and poor people. MashaAllah, there is one brother also, he came from Fiji. They're collecting some money, zakat and fitrah, and they're collecting some money for the iftar. If you want to give that money, you can give it to me, or you can give it to Imam Akram. We will collect it also. That brother is from Fiji. It's a good thing, brothers, if you don't have anybody here to give, we can send it to overseas. Help the people. There is a lot of orphanage, madrasa there, the children, they're learning Quran and Hadith. Inshallah, if you try to break the fast and then give them some zakat and fitrah. And also must understand, fitrah is $10. I think, but my Imam will make the announcement, it is $10 or maybe more. You must give the fitrah now. $10 per head. If a child born on the same day, before Salatul Fajr, you have to pay the fitrah for that person. If you have 5 people living in the house, you have to give $50 now. Should not delay, brothers. Our brothers, what they do, they take the fitrah on the day of Eid. That is not good. You have to give the fitrah. Why? Because you have to give the fitrah before the time that this fitrah money can reach to the needy people. They can benefit from this money on the day of Eid. And the people, they come on the last day of Eid, they say, Shaykh, this is my fitrah collected. And then what we're going to do this fitrah now? That fitrah should be go to the needy people in month of Ramadan. And inshallah, and also paying the fitrah is very important, because when if people are fasting and they have got a little bit problem in our fast, sometimes we do something wrong, we didn't fulfill our duties, because then when we make the fitrah, pay the fitrah, Allah accept the fast. Allah Ta'ala accept your fast direct. Otherwise, some of the hadith mentioned that your fast is hanging between the heaven and the earth. When you pay your fitrah and then this fast go, Allah Ta'ala accept. Allah will live. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah give us true understanding, brother. Whatever we listen, we try to practice in our daily life. Inshallah, that way Allah will make us successful in this life, in the life hereafter. Jazakumullah khair.